We are finishing up our titration section with some graphs to compare. For calculations, I will only ask you to calculate pHs at points in a strong acid, strong base titration, and a weak acid, strong base titration. This last section, though, I do expect that you would be able to determine what is in the flask at the beginning of a titration, and then what was being added to it, what was the titrant. So we're going to go through some examples here and discuss how you would approach answering a question like this. The first place to start is to, of course, figure out whether we have acid or base in solution. You can tell by starting pH. In this example, we are starting with a base. We must be titrating an acid with it. To determine the strength of those, we look at the pH value at our equivalence point. Notice in this example, our pH is at about a 7, and that happens when we add a strong acid with a strong base. And so we can therefore deduce that in the flask, we have our strong base. The titrant that we have added to it is our strong acid. We'll continue on with more examples. Same idea here. We, of course, know in our flask we have an acid because of our low pH. We are titrating it with a base. The strength of those is determined by the relative value of our pH at the equivalence point. Again, we have a pH of about 7. Therefore, we must have had a strong acid in the flask, and our titrant was a strong base. Our next example. Same steps. We know we have an acid in the flask. We're titrating with a base. And now we can tell our equivalence point is at a relatively high pH value. It is greater than 7. Remember, the equivalence point is determined by the salt. So we want to know the strength of the acid and base that will give us a basic salt. Hopefully we remember that that combination would be a weak acid in the flask titrated with a strong base. One more example. We are starting with a base in the flask titrating with an acid. We check the pH at our equivalence point and notice that it is a low pH, less than 7. The combination of acid and base that result in an acidic salt are, sorry, let's write that down, acidic salt at the equivalence point. That combination must be with a weak base in the flask, titrated with a strong acid. And one last slide to show is comparing strengths of acids or bases. We won't be focusing on the right graph, so we can ignore that one. But recognize that we can compare the strength of acids based on the length of the vertical section at the equivalence point. The stronger an acid at the same concentration, of course, the lower its initial pH would be, and therefore the steeper this vertical section will be with its equivalence point. As acids get weaker, their pKa values get higher, right? The Ka value starts to decrease. And so as pKa gets higher, we have a higher starting pH value. We therefore have a shorter vertical section. So again, we're showing as we get a weaker and weaker acid, our starting pH gets higher, our vertical section of the equivalence point gets weaker. So we could actually use titration curves to determine the relative strengths of acids as well. We will skip the next slide in here, and I will denote that on our Canvas page.